Hey guys, we got us a call, if I'm not mistaken, about a blank thermostat. So let's go in and see what's going on. Y'all forgive me, I'm a little bit shaky. I've been working out this morning. I want to see something. I don't know that that's the problem, but I bought a bunch of these 3-amp fuses off of Amazon, and I have had a couple problems with them being open even though they're not blown. And you just saw me wiggling that one around. That may not be the problem though. All right, let's see if we got power. All right, we got power and we got low voltage. Okay. Let me see if I can find a better fuse. I don't trust these fuses. Oh, we got us trees and limbs all in the way. I really just want to get to this one right here. Ooh, that's hot. Whew. watch that a little bit. That should be, I would hope it would get over 200. It's metering like it's supposed to. That is smoking hot. Watch that till it goes above 200. I typically like to see in temperatures like this, and it's on 54 degrees out here, I want to see this around 215, 220, 225. This is an older R22 system. If this were 410, I would want to see above 300. Looks like I've been out here. I'm gonna recommend to them just a regular PM on this one. That's something I got to get approval for before I can do it. Let's see what my pressures came out to be. We're at 209, 172 degrees. So that's good. All right, so that one just turned out to be a faulty fuse. It is one of these. It was not an Eaton fuse. It was one of these. Made in China, 50 in a box. When I bought them, my supply houses were having trouble getting any in stock, so I just ordered 100 of them off of Amazon, and that's actually the second time I found that, where the fuse is not blown, but it's not allowing voltage to pass. So now I'm gonna go look and see if I can get some more of those Eaton fuses. Those may have been cheap, but they ain't worth it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll catch you on the next one.